So now, reports do not have to be boring, and I really recommend you that you put time into making them as good looking as possible so users will want to interact with them. I'm going to show you some examples of reports that I have done so you can get inspiration of what you can do with your reports. Okay, so let's dive in again. The first report I want to show you, this is for my YouTube channel. I teach Power BI 3 times a week on YouTube. So I have, of course, a YouTube dashboard to collect insights about how I'm doing and how to improve. And this is the first page. It's just an infographic about, you know, important metrics on YouTube and some fun metrics too. So as you can see, it looks a bit quirky. There is no filters. There's nothing you can do. It's just facts. This is how well or how bad I am doing. I'm going to show you another example. This is, for example, for Google Analytics for my website, for curbal.com. And here I am measuring the site speed. Site speed is one of the key parameters for Google to rank your site. So here I'm looking at how am I doing in terms of site speed, how long it takes to load, and what are the different parameters that you have that compose the actual speed site. So here you can actually click on things. I can see the speed by location. So I can click on Africa, for example. That's where it takes the longest, but you might think that they don't have such good internet connections. So it makes sense basically, but I can click on a country and see how that specific country is doing and see if it's a problem that I have or is connection speed, so whatever it is. I have another example for the FIFA World Cup. When it was this year, I just made a report, downloaded data from the sites and from different sources, and I just put together a report to showcase Power BI. And here on the first page, you can select a group and a country, for example, B and Spain. And then you can go to the different pages and see how well they've done. I haven't refreshed this. The one that is refreshed is the one that is on the cloud. You can reset filters in case you want to do that. You can go back home in case you want to do that and change the filter. You know, this is some very nice functionality that Power BI has. I'm just showing you on the desktop. On the cloud, it looks absolutely fantastic. And here I have another example of sentiment score for a tech conference that I was helping them with. So you can see the scores for each speaker and whose speaker was the most appreciated, and everything was live. We were using IoT Hub and Event Hub. We were using SQL, Power BI, the whole shaboom. So this was a fun project. Yeah, so now hopefully you get a good understanding of what Power BI is and what it can do for you. So next up, how much does it cost? Don't miss that.